The Nigeria Police is the principal law enforcement and lead security agency in Nigeria, with a staff strength of about 371,800. There are currently plans by the federal government to increase the force to a number of 650,000, adding 280,000 new recruits to the existing number. This is the keynote address by IGP Adamuye Mohammed, NPM, MNI, on mass sensitization of members of public on community policing, delivered by me, and I take responsibility for whatever I say from this keynote address. Community policing or community-oriented policy is a strategy of policy that focuses on developing relationship with community members with a view to solving common problems to the interest of all involved. Community policing is all about police partnership with the members of the community that is being policed with a view to solving and combating crime. In the face of apparently soaring levels of crime and criminality, the Nigerian government launched community policy initiative in 1999. However, the present government, under the leadership of the President Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR, President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, commendably prioritized internal security amongst his three-point agenda, which include corruption, economic recovery, security, which is embedded in policy. The concept of community policy in the 21st century has gone beyond the mundane approach of policy. Rather than policing of the community, it is policing with the community, that means policing with the people, which connotes security is every citizen's business, everybody's business. Community policy is a strategy of combating crime. The IGP's Wamedi Adamu, MPMNI, is so passionate, as it is the only almighty formula in solving crime, criminality, and a veritable measure in crisis management situation in the nation. On the 26th June 2020, in his inaugural speech of Southwest Community Policy Advisory Committee in Oyo State, the IGP said that to guarantee safety and strengthen internal security, we require a security roadmap, hence the adoption of community policy as an edge to conventional policy strategy. Community policy as a policy model rests on the philosophy and principles of public partnership, intelligence gathering, inter as well as multi-agency collaboration and problem solving. As we all recall the policy challenges during the NSAS saga, it's revealed that there is a gap between the police and the community that is being policed. Thus, the need for collaboration, cooperation, partnering, and synergy with the community, as well as all critical stakeholders, as we are all sitting here today, cutting across every aspect of our endeavor in this country. This led to the disbandment of the Federal Special Anti-Robbery Squad and gave birth to SWAT, and eventually led to the recruitment of Special Constabulary. Special Constabulary personnel were taken from the community, trained by the police upon deployment into these communities, and they will serve as a bridge between the police and the community. Hence, the demand to continually sensitizing, educating, and informing the community on the need to partner with the police, which is the paramount tool. Today's occasion marks another milestone in the history of community policy in the southwest of the country, based on the achievement made so far and the desire for people to face policy based on trust and confidence between the public and the police. Let me succinctly proceed that the governors, the traditional rulers, private individuals, the clergy, the academia, the intelligentsia, and all other professionals, as well as critical stakeholders within southwest of this country, have keyed into the vision of community-based policing, which has a roadmap of drastically reducing crime rates and criminality, and also to further enhance a cohesive relationship in all aspects of security management architecture. And I believe the equations and the contents of community policy, when you look at it, cutting across all strata, is the only key. It is the only mighty formula that can bring everybody, that can bring all agencies, either security management agencies, either private agencies, the clear, the intelligence, and everybody together, to form a threshold whereby some of these problems can be looked at and we find a solution to it based on our national drive, as well as our cultural different diversity. I therefore thank each and every one of you today who are still here, and I wish you a happy and fruitful technical session deliberation. Thank you, and God bless.